Welcome back again to Engineer Tina Academy. It's your guy Christine, and on today's video we want to look at analysis of rates. We've been doing building up unit rates, but we've not actually analyzed what is these rates that we are building. So before we proceed, thank you guys for your support. Thank you for the subscription. If you're new here, you know how we do it. Subscribe, share, and don't forget to leave a comment. Maze, you've been so amazing. So let's now proceed to looking at these analysis of rates. Estimation is a key element in the construction, and so we need to do the analysis. So let's start by defining what analysis of rates is. You find that in order to determine the rates of a particular item, the factors affecting the rates of the item should be studied carefully. All those factors that will affect the unit rate of that item. And finally, a rate is decided for that item. This is now the process of determining the rates of an item is now termed as analysis of rates or rate analysis. So that is basically what we've been doing. We've been building up unit rates for excavation, concrete works, formwork, doors, and all those elements in construction. Now the rates, particularly the rates of the particular items of work, depends on various items. Okay, you'll find that the rates of cement depends on particular item, the rates of formwork depends on particular formwork, but generally the rates of the items have specific particular items that they depend on. Number one item is the specification of the works and the material. This is very key, it's very element, it's very crucial. The specification, when you talk about the specification of works and the material, we are talking about the quality. Quality of the work, it's specified what you are supposed to produce. And then we have the proportion that is now whereby we go by the ratio that you are supposed to use. And then we have the construction operation method. What method are you using for so that you can be able to come up with the best quality? Remember, we are not supposed to compromise on quality. It's very crucial. So that is number one factor that we are going to look at when we are building our unit rate. Number two, we need to look at the quantity of material and their cost. Hey, when we come to quantity, when we come to the cost of material, it's also very crucial, because without the right cost of the material, we might end up messing the rates. So we must consider the cost of material. And then when we are considering the cost of material are taken as delivered to site. That includes the transport that you're going to need. It includes all the logistics, that is the local tax and other charges that are included. So they should all be inclusive when you are looking at the cost of the material. Now, once you have the cost of material, the another aspect that you're going to look at is the cost of labor and their wages. Remember, some cost of labor and their wages, they are standard rates, they are scheduled on the rates, and then the other ones you can just form them. So the labor are classified. We have skilled first class. That is, those are the first class, and then we have skilled second class, and then we have the unskilled. Remember, the labor wages can be obtained from the standard schedule of rates. We've said mostly it's 30% of the skilled labor provided in the data may be taken as first class, and then the remaining 70% will be taken as second class or the unskilled. Now, if you have the labor, now you're going to look at the location. Number three factor is the location of the site. That is the location of the site of work and the distance for sourcing the materials. For convenience purposes, ensure that the lead distance, that is the distance from where you are sourcing your material to the where the project is convenience. And then the lead distance, now that is the lead statement, that is the distance should be in kilometers. And then once we have the lead distance, the another thing that you are going to look at is the profits and overheads. Remember, we are in business, we must give the established charges, and we also need to make a profit at the end of it. So guys, those are the six factors that you look at when you are preparing Union analyzing your rates. Now, once you have your factors in position, now you can be able to build up unit rates. Remember, we've built up different unit rates and we'll continue building up more unit rates. So, guys, that is all for today. Thank you for your time. Thank you for your support. You are such amazing people. Until next time, bye bye.